Hey guys, Third Street Reactions here. We're back. I'm Shane.
Zach.
And we're back here with a new show. Guys, if this is your first time being here, make sure you go back and check out WandaVision, Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Did I get that right that time?
You did.
Usually I say,
Captain Falcon. Falcon!
Captain Falcon, the Winter Soldier. And also the Loki series. We have a bunch of stuff, so go back and check it out. And we're pretty excited to jump into this. So yeah, we watched the trailer and reacted to that. You can go back and check that out from a few months ago. And Haley Steinfeld had this Die Hard type feel to it. Kind of, they're in the city, it's holidays, and
yeah, it had a very Die Hard feeling to it.
Yeah, which is never a bad thing.
But a lot of people have been paying a lot of tribute to that. I know the Lego Movie.
Okay.
Had Bruce Willis in it.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, and a little,
that's awesome.
Had a little Lego Bruce Willis in the ductwork, and the, I think the Evil Queen's little place. So,
yeah.
I think there's a lot of, I don't know, a lot of traction there with that idea there, I guess.
Yeah, that Die Hard feeling. People crave that thing, and that's because Die Hard's great.
It is great, but a lot of people wouldn't know what it is or be able to appreciate it, you know, for what it was.
Well, it's not Star Wars, but I think it's infiltrated culture enough.
Well, it's infiltrated culture now. It's gaining traction now. It's like, well,
yeah,
it's actually a Christmas movie, and now people are picking it up and running with it, which is fine because it's a great movie.
Yeah.
So,
which is your favorite one?
The first one. Third one's really good, but the first one's the best.
They've all been pretty good.
Second one's pretty. It's not great, but it's okay.
Well, I don't remember the second one at all. But I remember the third or fourth. I love Live Free or Die Hard. I actually haven't seen the fifth one.
Well, Live Free or Die Hard has Timothy Oliphant in it, right?
Yeah, and yeah. Justin DeLong, and it was the only one rated PG-13.
Well,
it's still great. The action's great, and he's great, and it's a new kind of terrorism.
Yeah.
That being said, Hawkeye looks great. And we don't know anything else about it. I love Hawkeye the character. Jeremy Renner's cool, and he's great in Wind River.
And yeah, I liked him in Wind River. I liked that movie.
Yeah.
And
Hayley Steinfeld's great, too. I saw her in a few things.
Well,
most recently, Bumblebee.
I saw her in True Grit and Bumblebee. That's all I've seen.
Pretty much.
I'm a big fan of True Grit. Either way, I'm looking forward to this. I'm hoping it's just enjoyable. I don't know a lot about the character myself.
I don't know if it's going to... Yeah, and I don't think it's going to do what Loki did. It looks like it's going to be smaller.
We had the team building and the everything that the new Captain America has to deal with. And then you had Loki kind of building up the new great threat to the Marvel Universe.
Yeah, and then WandaVision was Wanda's personal story more than, I think, something in terms of building the MCU like Loki did.
Yeah.
Let's jump in. You got a daughter to think of. So she's daddy's girl.
You shouldn't eavesdrop.
Then how would I know what you're saying when I'm not there?
I don't know how to argue with that.
Mommy said things don't just fall from the sky.
Well, yeah, but there's always going to be weather.
Something's going to fall in that fucking sky.
Some people forget the one thing they can't do.
Whether in New York?
The choices they make. I would do what I always do. Protect you. Now.
The Hawkeye saved her.
If you just saw that shit,
we have to get out of here.
It'd be so profound.
You're fucking crazy. Yeah, we're dealing with heat.
What if they come back?
They won't come back.
How do you know?
Because the heroes showed them what would happen.
So gymnastics, archery, and fencing.
It's a grand little montage that you always like in the very beginning.
You gotta have Sylvester Stallone as well.
He makes a good montage, there's no question.
Kate, careful. We do come back.
caught, you're definitely going to be kicked off the archery team.
Yeah, I know.
So the real question, does the bell swing back and forth, or does the dangling thingy in the middle swing back and forth?
It's obviously the bell.
I know it's a bet,
but are you sure that arrow won't damage it?
No.
The arrow would go right through that ball, right? I don't know about the tip. I don't know what kind of tips you got in there.
Well, that was a bit of a letdown.
Okay.
Dude, that's awful. Not, I mean, you just go to jail, probably, you know?
You don't get expelled.
Well, what bothered me about making a movie like this is they're probably making the fucking summer.
Yeah. Left wearing all that shit.
Yeah.
That guy, George Bush? Who the fuck is that guy?
He looks familiar.
I could do this all day. This line.
Yeah.
I know what happened, Sears. I was there. You know who wasn't there? It's that guy. Ant-Man.
I just love how he's so weirded out by it.
You ought to be. Imagine George Washington seeing shit.
Yeah.
We portray now.
Or if people know he's Hawkeye. The bathroom fight scene.
Right.
What? Yeah, I guess you would have that kind of graffiti, you know?
Oh, a selfie would be really rad, dude. My kids would
flip. Jesus, fuck.
You know, it's not really the appropriate time.
Now a better
time. Why is everyone singing and dancing about everything?
I don't know. But it's Christmas in New York.
Well, it's weird because there was so much catastrophe that happened. It'd be like if doing a song and dance about 9/11. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I understand that they saved the world.
Why did Claire write down a note about civilians in war? They all civilians are being killed.
There you are.
Jesus.
Oh, you look
that's a dress.
Amazing. As much as I love having you home for the holidays, I'm not thrilled that I'm about to replace an irreplaceable clock tower.
It is a bell tower.
The dean said it had a bell and a clock, and overachiever that you are, you managed to destroy both.
She's lucky she didn't get spanked. If I destroyed a block,
different
we destroyed an air. What would you do? What would your dad do?
I don't know. My dad might be in awe.
They didn't spank.
He'd be like, that was a good shot.
You did a second time. Not fun anymore.
It was funny the first time.
Yeah.
Sorry.
That's a slap on the fucking wrist, kid.
No.
Hun, there have been a few changes while you're away this semester.
Charlotte?
Jack!
Oh. Who the fuck's this guy?
Jack!
Go change. Meet us at the hotel and we'll talk there, okay?
shall we?
Let's. We'll see you at the party.
See you there,
honey. Party.
I want to know what this guy can do with a sword, first of all. There's been some changes, and he walks in with a rose.
Peace.
Yeah.
Dina, Sonas. Thank you.
Almas, that's not necessary.
It's necessary. You saved our city.
Thank you.
What a complaint about that. Jerry Seinfeld had this funny bit where he's talking about people offer him like all kinds of, I'll take it. I guarantee I didn't vote for that guy, they did for me. He was talking to Bill Maher. Bill Maher doesn't like when... Bill Maher's like, I don't like when people give me ups in line. And Jerry's like, I'll take it. I love it. Why wait? It was hilarious. I mean, he's probably joking, but...
Yeah. This guy looks like a schmuck.
I'm not a waitress.
You're the little bishop girl.
Yes, I am.
I'm on Duquesne. You used to come to my brownstone for brunch.
I know them from something.
I'd appreciate it if you wear something a little more ladylike for the wedding, so we won't be competing.
What wedding?
You don't know. Ellen and Jack. God, those secretive little lovebirds. When he gets something set in that little mind of his, he can be quite determined.
There's been two passive-aggressive comments from this guy so far.
So does he. I'm not so sure.
That little thing of his.
I want to go home. I'm bored.
That's no way to talk, Mom. That's not the way you were brought up. Come and say hello to Miss Bishop.
You're bored of this.
Aren't you fucking Stannis?
Yeah.
You need to have a chat with your prize of a mother. Come on. Come on.
You're engaged?
Oh, well, I guess the beans are out of the bag.
The beans?
This guy!
Yeah, of course.
The nose, he's a gonzo. I don't like him. He's got the look of a man that
the jury's
I
jury's out.
Like.
I don't know yet.
I'm sorry, I don't like him.
I can't judge someone immediately. That's not how I am.
I can't.
I'm not a judge.
All the time.
So I don't think a sword is...
Armand. Mom, what was that about? Is that guy threatening you? I honestly have no idea.
Why
are you lurking in the hallways?
Why is he walking alone down fucking storage corridors?
He's going his lair. But maybe he's like the guy from The Mask of Zorro. He won't look at a servant. You know what I mean?
Yeah, maybe.
Don Raphael.
You'll never be rid of me. This seat is cold.
Oh.
Great.
I thought I was supposed to be the only one working here.
Gary? Gary sent me to work here? Send me if you want to bother Gary.
Gotta look a little stuck up.
You're a piece of shit. Look at him.
Who told you to come down here?
Gary.
I'm Gary.
That little what's fucker.
You see, that's the problem, Gary. You don't even know my name. You know, this is not gonna work out. I quit.
You can't quit. Come on.
Yeah, she had him convinced for a second. Come on, man.
Excuse me.
Taking some of that vintage vineyard there.
Yeah.
Swiping off the fucking shelf. Stuff in my pocket with.
So good. Down.
Now you can own this one-of-a-kind retractable sword.
Whoa, that's fucking cool.
Do I hear 250? 250, thank you, sir. Do I hear 300? 300, looking for 350.
What are you doing, you dope?
I'm buying that sword.
We don't have 300 grand.
No, but I'll inherit it one day, won't I?
Talk measuring contest. How would you know how to retract it? What if he just hit it and it went through his fucking kidney?
Uh-oh.
Oh,
Hello.
He's got to recognize her, right? I think that was a look of recognition.
It was definitely a look.
Oh, shit.
The big fucking hole. With the firing buckshot.
Oh, things. Shit.
I found it.
Get off me! I'm gonna get you, you dumb duck!
Kind of look like a big toilet with a trench coat.
You're on LaGuardia, right?
A ninja saved a dog.
Amazing.
Isn't that awesome,
Dad? Motherfucker. This is the first potential sighting of the Ronin. Action. Go on. Get
away.
I like pizza.
You scarf that shit down.
Now, bro. Why are you making it so tough on us, bro?
Please break that.
Cut his wrist, bust his fucking wrist open. What we thought of it.
That was a reaction. No, this is what we thought of it.
I don't know. It was okay. I didn't think it was bad by any means.
I liked it. It's taking its time.
Yeah.
You know, they didn't introduce him right away and stuff like that. I liked how they met. And yeah, I figured he would show up, kind of like Batman. It's always a good thing.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm pretty intrigued with the mystery of her mom and the boyfriend. And now fucking Armand is dead. And I'm really, I really like his voice. There's something really weird about it.
Armand?
Or... Yeah, Armand. Yeah, it's something.
Well, he's from something else we've seen. I don't remember what he's from, but I've seen that.
Probably
man.
Should have looked in the credits.
Right there.
Damn it!
Ow!
I meant to press.
No!
I meant to press pause. I pressed back. So take it from the top. We start out with a little flashback when everything went down in New York.
But no, you're right. I don't fucking care if you quote me on it, but it's like Vera Farmiga, okay? I mean, she's in this.
I think she's more than just a mom.
So well, I always think she's rich and entwined with shit that the rich people get into because they're bored.
Yeah, they're going to start a fucking Squid Game.
I guess. You know, like, you'll know.
Yeah.
You know, so these fucking people are
squabbling
about their Squid Game. In the meantime, the goddamn Shintari and everything are fucking invading New York and blowing shit up. And...
Exactly. I really appreciate the detail that, you know, obviously he's in this play, so you see kind of the commercialization of the Avengers.
Yeah, like we deal with on everyday life.
Yeah, it kind of reminds me of like a scaled down version of The Boys, where there's a commercialization of the heroes. Except they own their brand, so at least they're getting some of it. And fucking, he's not getting shit.
No, he must have some money. He's out there ordering these fucking dinner for 30 people and shit. And...
Well, what was it? It was something that we watched where it was like Tony didn't pay them. Like, they didn't get paid for anything.
Yeah, it was Falcon the Winter Soldier.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He was talking about the stipends where we discussed whether or not they ought to have been paid. Like, he was trying to get a bank loan, and the bank wouldn't give him a fucking bank loan. He's like, well, we know who you are. We love you. I want a signature, a selfie or something, but we can't help you.
Which is ridiculous.
Yeah, it's very ridiculous.
Which is ridiculous.
So, well, I get it. You know, it's life. Life's a paper trail, and you ain't got a pedigree, then banking will fucking help you.
So, no, you're right.
They just ship you to Hawaii. One for a fucking one-way ticket.
Yeah.
And you just go out there and die.
Better than North Korea.
You get, I mean, it is. So
I'm above the
even when you're a bum, you get... First class treatment.
Yeah, hopefully I'm above the height.
You can go die on the height beach. Range.
Yeah. You know what they do with short people over there?
They do, but I'm sure you're taller than Kim Jong-un or Il, whichever one that is that's in control over there now.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
I made a note about civilians in war.
Okay, what'd you think of that?
Well, because you talked about, you know, how they've made light of the Avengers and the events that happened and through the musical.
Yeah, there's like the commercialization.
But they talk about Kate Bishop's experience and how these fucking all these civilians are being killed left and right in New York, you know, through the invasion. And it was just like in with Zemo.
Yeah.
And how his family was killed because of the Avengers' actions and all that shit that was going on.
And Scarlet Witch. And
yeah, and so he...
Quicksilver.
And that's just case in point. You know, there's a lot of collateral damage.
Yeah.
And warfare, and we just take it for granted for the spectacle. We all love the spectacle, especially as Americans in first world countries that can afford to eat that shit up and go about our daily lives, where there are people in the world that just have to suffer through that every day.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I guess I felt like having a musical about, like, that. I mean, I understand having a musical with the characters, but when you're talking about that event that you see the ship flying in between the skyscrapers, like, well, I think that could offend some people. It's been about... It's like 10 years plus 5 years because of the snap.
So. Well, I feel like we're like, right now, we're like the Germany before Germany fucking became Nazi Germany.
I mean, I could talk about that all night. I won't.
I know, but that's how I feel like our environment is right now, because Germany had a very enlightened social class and educated class.
It's
because
the French intellectuals came in. And
First World War, the whole time period.
Yeah, the French intellectuals, they came in, they started all this enlightened bullshit.
Prior to the First World War, like, Germany was kind of like top of the line in the world,
yeah,
in terms of education and shit like that. And then the First World War happened, and they were engaged in the political entanglements that drew them into that, and they lost, and then things developed from there.
Yeah,
and you had this country that was so well developed that they could only go like one of two ways, and the traditional way turned out to be what we got.
Yeah, and obviously he was having flashbacks because of Natasha, and I knew they were close. I didn't know it was his best friend.
Well, yeah, they talk about that. Okay, Avengers movies.
I didn't remember. Yeah, I knew they were close, but it was good to have that detail. And I hear about this stuff a lot. Actually, we were talking about Jerry Seinfeld. He walked into the he was in a restaurant with his kids, and I said, "Oh, you don't have to pay." And Jerry Seinfeld, you know, this guy is hilarious. I don't know if it's true or not. It might be. He's talking to Bill Maher, and Bill Maher's like, "I usually accept most things. Like, if people want this, they want to wave me through the crosswalk or whatever when the light is green." But like, one thing he doesn't like is like, if we're in line to do something, is they get ticket ups. And Jerry's like, "I do. I'll take it. Whatever." You know, if you're a war vet and people eat this thing crazy, people go, "Hey, they buy you drinks, and you won't pay for drinks the rest of your life. You go to these bars."
I think it's very different if you're a war vet compared to a celebrity.
Well, he's a war vet. I mean, fought Hawkeye. A war. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That's what I'm talking about.
That makes, okay, we're not Steinfeld.
No.
Yeah, it's like what...
So, like, in that particular case, I see kind of someone who's disillusioned with everything that's happened. He sees a commercialization of it. He misses Natasha. Yes, he saved the world, but I think he just kind of wants to live his life with his kids. He wants his kids to experience something that's a little more normal.
Yeah.
So I get that. Like, it's telling me, I believe in that character not wanting to have his food given to him for free. You know what I mean? At the same time, on the other side, I bet maybe Sam and Bucky, they might, you know, They look like specifically that show. And
well, they're not the bigger names in the business, so they have no money. So no. The perspective's a little bit different. So they're like, oh, well, hell yeah, I mean, okay.
Well, and I'm sorry, what's his name?
Bucky hangs out in fucking bars, and
the guy in the first Winter Soldier, the Super Soldier program, the old black guy.
Yeah, Isaiah.
He got fucked. You know, I think he should get some food, man.
He did get fucked.
Yeah.
But he came to terms with it.
Yeah, he did.
And he's like, the point of him getting fucked.
And then he got that statue in him, whatever.
Yeah. And he developed a strength of his own because of him getting fucked.
Yeah.
And he, you know, came into his own because of it. So
yeah
it doesn't mean that I think it's right or wrong. I'm just saying that
yeah.
you know, he was able to develop himself in spite of it.
Yeah. We had the guy at the urinal. You know, and he's a little older, man. Come on. Yeah, I understand. I understand that type of thing, but don't ever.
Well, I don't know. Like, some people just, they see celebrities and they fucking go gaga for them. I don't, for one, feel that way. Like, I don't even know what the hell you talk to them about. It's like, you like their work, but what else are you going to ask
them
about?
That's pretty much it.
Weather?
Like, this is relevant to Seinfeld. Jerry said, it happens to him all the time, but he always, absolutely always takes a selfie or whatever, because he says part of the job. And you have to understand how privileged. I understand how privileged I am to be in this position, because a lot of people would kill for it. But he said, the only time I will say no is someone asks me on the urinal. And that's exactly what I was thinking of. It's just, you know, wait.
Well, the urinal thing was bad timing.
Yeah.
But
it's not appropriate. It's exactly what he said.
The fucking bathroom and shit, yeah.
So, and I guess, like, the older I get, the more I feel like, okay, you know, I don't want to. I saw, when I was at Star Wars Celebration, I saw a few people.
Mm-hmm.
Janina Gavankar.
It's a hell of a name. It's a mouthful.
Yeah, she was on The League and a few other things, and she played in Battlefront 2 as a main protagonist.
Okay.
I saw her, I just kept looking at her, I'm thinking, what the hell is she here for? Like, I do know celebrities come and they wear masks, because they're just like Star Wars, and they walk around convention floor with like just a Vader mask or a Stormtrooper mask, like one with a string in the back, just so they don't get recognized. But I thought, okay, and I was a member of the press at the time who got there before everyone, but there's still like hundreds of people there. And she was just walking around. I'm thinking, is that her? Look, I was just staring at her. And there's this guy who's like 6'8" walking with her. I'm thinking, and he looked at me. And I'm like, I looked away. And he said, hey. I said, hey, what's up? And he came over to me. He's like, you know who that is? I said, I think it's Shiva from The League. Because I couldn't remember how to pronounce her last name. But, you know, I'm not sure. I don't know why she'd be walking around here for. And he said, go ask her for a picture. I said, I'm not doing that. No way. Yeah, I'm not going to be one of those assholes. He said, oh, she doesn't care. I said, I don't even know if it's her. And then he came over and got her. And he's like, and she just was he was just doing the fuck with her and fuck with me. And she was the nicest person. It's an interesting detail. Thanos was right. What'd you think of that?
That was funny.
I imagine there's definitely be these fucking but dudes wearing fucking, all black.
With yeah, but what if they were the ones that were fucking gone?
I mean, like if they came back?
Yeah, like, what if they were the ones that were snapped out? Maybe they wouldn't feel that way. It's like people would just take for granted that shit. It's like, well Thanos is right. All these other assholes were gone. Life was better. It was like, well, if you were fucking gone, you wouldn't know.
Yeah.
You wouldn't know how good it was or how bad it was.
I can imagine in both situations, like, if you got snapped out and came back, and then, like, your wife moved on, your kid died, and all
that. Well, I get that. Yeah, if you came back and everything sucked.
Or if you...
How long was it?
5 years.
5 years. So if you were gone 5 years and your whole family moved on from you and it was just a shock...
Or if, on the flip
side...
You had
no job or anything else, you were a fucking bum now.
Yeah, or if on the flip side, if you didn't get snapped back, well, all your family left, and then you had to go through this emotional trauma, and then they came back, it wasn't the same. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but I could imagine that you'd blame Thanos. I mean, I would blame Thanos more for them doing it and causing that.
I feel
that
like, perspective. I feel like I would too, but...
Yeah, but, you know, but being the guy that got snapped out, how the fuck would you know, dude?
I don't know.
It's like the neo-Nazis now. They say the Nazis are right. Well, motherfucker, those Nazis lost. Okay, and their women were raped in the streets, and their cities were burned and bombed, and their country suffered deplorably for what happened.
Yeah.
And you're going to tell me the Nazis were right? No. No, they were not.
I agree, so. Yeah. Yeah, so, I mean, I just imagine, you know, some 20-something-year-old kid writing that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I
know. Or some teenager.
Some fucking asshole. How do you feel about the Christmas spirit?
When I was a little kid, I felt it more than I do now. But then as my kids are getting older, I mean, or they're excited about Christmas, I've experienced it through them and their excitement, you know, and I'm really happy for them. But in terms of myself, I try absolutely the hardest I can to separate how I am and what I like for my kids. But sometimes I get sucked into those things.
Okay.
And Christmas is one of them. Like today we had Thanksgiving, we had Christmas music, and everyone was helping.
Christmas music.
And it felt really nice. Yeah. Really? They put it on. But they liked it, and...
Yeah, well, whatever. But I just...
Yeah.
I don't know. Like, people are rushing Christmas. I felt like it was...
No,
like
I think that's...
A week before Thanksgiving,
I don't like
they were
people
already
who,
putting Christmas out there.
Yeah, I don't like people who rush Christmas. I don't dislike those people. I'm saying is, like, I don't do that.
I don't like the commercialization of it. And like, it's like, all of a sudden, the lights are going up a week before Thanksgiving, and it's like, well, Christmas is coming! And
yeah,
it's like, it's the money time of the year.
Well, that's when we make the most on YouTube and everything else. Yeah, it's
interesting. Well, I get it, because people are at home, they want to relax, they kick up their feet by the proverbial fire, and they sit back and have a beer, or a hot cocoa, or whatever the fuck, and watch YouTube.
Yeah.
Or movies, and whatever, it's fine, but I just, it's like, there's no...
I remember my aunt Cheryl used to babysit me, and I remember making these rings. Like, you know, you ring them, you glue them together, and they're just paper.
Mm-hmm.
And you tear one off every day closer to Christmas. I remember feeling such anticipation, excitement in that spirit back then. And then I didn't feel it when I was older, and I feel like I feel that now for my kids. You know what I mean?
Well, I mean, the kids, I mean...
That's... Yeah, I tried not to. You know what I mean? But I do.
Yeah.
So it's just...
No, I understand.
Yeah.
The Russian tracksuits, man, that's... fucking gets me. I don't know. I've met some Russians when I was in New York. Like, none of them were in tracksuits, so it's like,
yeah.
I guess they weren't mobsters, but
I don't know. I mean, I've met a few. I was pretty close to one, and it was definitely in his wardrobe. He had one of every color, but he didn't wear it every day. But he said, like in high school when he was there, that's everyone wore. And I would talk about the gangsters. He said they were wearing funny, like you said, Armani suits. Like, if they're the boss or the muscle, they're wearing tracksuits. That's just kind of how it is.
I guess. Maybe it was back then. It just seems like, I don't know, it's America, I guess. Like, people don't wear fucking tracksuits now.
It's a part of their culture now. It's like, you know, we're more Nike and they're more Adidas. Adidas tracksuits is what they wear. If you wear a Nike thing, they'll kill you, I guess. Yeah, it's very sacrilegious over there. It's really weird, yeah.
All right. Monochrome butterscotch.
Butterscotch candy I love. My grandma used to have them in her jar all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So it just...
It is good.
Yeah.
Like butterscotch pudding, it's great.
But,
you know, the monogram shit, when you're rich and powerful, I guess.
Oh, okay. I just understand what you meant.
What? He had it on there. Who the fuck else monograms shit?
I don't know. It just,
people that can afford it, I can tell you that.
I guess I would, instead of monogramming candy, I would just get nice ass, well agreed upon, like this is some of the best candy ever, and I just wouldn't put my name on it. Yeah. I'd rather have the name brand of that candy, I guess. Like if you're going to fucking buy expensive candy, flex it and keep the fucking, you know, put the Andes Mints, keep that on there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And just, we're talking about the commercialization, and it's funny enough, this is a Christmas, not movie, but Christmas-themed show. There's a commercialization that goes with Christmas. But they're auctioning off Ronan's gear. His sword, his suit.
Yeah.
And,
well, it's like the rich and powerful.
Yeah.
And then they're in a wine cellar.
Yeah.
Are auctioning off fucking Triceratops skulls. And
yeah. The sword was really cool. But that Triceratops skull is awesome.
I think I'd rather have that. What the fuck are you going to do with the sword?
I love a story where we have just a young kid, particularly a girl... I really love Katniss Everdeen. I love her. I love Rey from Star Wars. Just when they take hold and they're thrust, you know, and of course their destiny is thrust upon them.
Yeah.
But they kind of jump into it head first.
Yeah.
And they're brave, and it's always great story, I think. And it never gets old for me. You know what? When I saw Vera in the red dress, it made me think of The Matrix.
Well, yeah, the red dress and mouse.
Yeah.
And all that.
Good old mouse.
I was talking about her tits hanging in the dress. How you feel about this red dress?
Well, she looked pretty great in that, I have to say. You know, and she's just beautiful, and she's, you know, she's pretty timeless with her looks.
Yeah, it worked out.
I don't got anything else. I'm liking the show. I like the pace. They're taking the time. But now they have met.
I like that this seems like an actual film in terms of its beginning.
I guess it does. It does feel like the first 10 minutes of a movie.
It does. It feels like it's building up in a film, and I appreciate that. It's not like it's just fucking crazy-ass shit going on. It's like slow and timed. And
yeah, I mean, I know we have Spider-Man coming up here soon, but it's great. Like, these formats now have really kind of reprogram my mind a little bit in terms of the pace and flow and of a story and taking your time. I mean, we have a lot of big name actors jumping into HBO miniseries and stuff like that. We had, obviously, in the early, the late 2000s, things like True Detective and stuff like that, mm-hmm. where these actors would do it. Now we have, obviously, the Marvel Universe. We have the Star Wars Cinematic Universe. Yeah. And it's like, wow, you know, like, you can almost tell a better story in this format. I don't got anything else. We're going to watch the second one, so we're going to shut this down, but that's it. Guys, thank you so much for watching our reaction, our discussion. Hope you enjoyed it. Welcome to our channel if it's your first time being here. And if you like us, you want to support us, just like and subscribe, hit that notification, leave a comment down below.
Yeah.
Yeah.